everybody. I'm Blessed and Free. Welcome back to another episode of DOC TV. So today we have somebody on who's been on the channel before. It's Trey. She doesn't want to show her face because, you know, she's changed her life around. She has a good job and she doesn't want it to affect that. So you kind of got to respect that. But she's got a crazy story. She robbed 7 banks, went to federal prison. And I'm going to link part one to this interview in the description of this interview so you guys can go check that out. But we left off, you know, she's in prison and we're going to get into some federal prison stories today. If you're new, man, this is what we talk about on this channel. So go ahead and hit that subscribe button and turn your post notifications on all. So every time I do drop an episode, you can hear it first. Why don't you go ahead and just say what's up to everybody again, and then we'll go ahead and get into it.
What's up?
So you're in federal prison. Did you get into any relationships when you were in prison?
Hell yeah. Yeah.
Okay. Sure. Why you say it like that? Like you were just savaging up in there or what?
No, but it's just kind of a given. You know what I mean? Like I went in, I was gay before I went, you know, so, you know, I fuck with females. So.
Like, how did it work for you? Because, you know, the reason why I'm asking is because, like, I've watched some lockup or all shit, you know, and they call them studs in there. And that's like, I guess the girls that look like a dudes, right?
Yeah. They call it that out here in the free world too. It's okay. So like, I don't know about state. So a lot of stories that I've heard about state from all over seem horrible. So it was nothing like that. Like there is a lot of drama. I got stabbed in the knee. It wasn't nothing serious, but one of the chicks I was fucking with stabbed me in the knee.
Hold on, what? So yeah. how did all that go down?
She was my chick. So in the feds, like they do like this, you can pick your housing. Like at this time I was like kind of like the bad kid, you can kind of say. So like if you could like literally go to the lieutenant and be like, hey, can you move this person in my room? And they would move them. They didn't care. They felt like, okay, whatever. It'll cut down on all the drama. So we were cellies and tried to end it, and I was getting ready to go home. And you know, anybody that's been in prison knows if you are new or if you're a short timer, you come in and you only got, you know, under 10, you don't fuck with anybody that's got over 20, and you damn sure don't fuck with a lifer, because no matter how much they think or say they love you, it ain't. All that shit in there is sick and twisted, and they'll take your fucking date. And so it was getting close for me to leave, and I had already lost because I got 2 indictments. So the first indictment, I lost all my good days on that one. So I was like, nah, fuck that. I'm not finna keep losing good days behind bitches I ain't never gonna see again. And most of the females in prison aren't gay, but they're all fucking, you know what I mean? They're not gay. They're going home. They're on the phone with their, you know, their their boyfriends or their baby daddies or whatever. But I don't know what it is, but they just go crazy. They go crazy. I had a chick scratch her own, like one of the chicks I was fucking with in Texas. I tried to stop fucking with her and she scarred her own face with her own hands. Like she clawed down the side of her face with her own hands and tried to like say I did it. Well, it was on camera, so I didn't get in trouble, but she was fucking certified. Them bitches are crazy. Like they like in
that's Man, what Trey, you be giving it to them. You got bitches trying to kill themselves.
No, it ain't even that. It be bitches that's not even gay that can have people that have them doing that. It's just
when you say they're not gay, but you say they're fucking, that's gay though, then right?
It's not. It's all no. It's like okay. I used to say this. Okay, so you know, like when you go to the zoo,
if a dude goes to prison and he sucks dick in prison and then he gets out. That he's gay, like to me. That's not how it works for y'all.
In my opinion, no. It's called needs met. We're all animals. At the end of the day, we're fucking animals. We're just a different form. We're different species, but we're all animals. You see a dog, they'll fuck in the middle of the street because they're an animal. We have animalistic ways. So if you pull a person out of human contact for so long, they're gonna want their dick tickled, or you know what I mean? They gonna want something. You know what I mean? I could be wrong, but in my opinion.
I know what you're saying. It's just like, I don't know. But I get what you're saying about the animalistic ways. Would you say that prison escalates that in someone when they're in there?
Yeah. Yeah. I think so. Well, I think females become more needy. A lot of them get fucking dissed. They don't have their kids and shit. They're fucking depressed. So yeah, they want to lay up and get held and fucked on. That don't mean that they would do it in public. That doesn't mean they're going to go home and walk around in Walmart with a girlfriend. Some will, but 90% of them, no. That they're just, it's just getting your needs met at the time. You know what I mean? You walk out them gates, you that ain't nobody going to fucking know. That's how it is with men too. My brother told me that. He's like, my brother, he was independent in state. And he told me, he's like, listen, after like 20, I think he's 10 or some shit like that, they don't even consider it gay. It's, I don't know if it's old, like you have to suck somebody's dick if they've been there 10. I don't know, but.
What state is that in that he went and did that?
He was in, he didn't get his dick sucked, but I mean,
I know, but what state was that in?
Indiana.
Indiana, and that's state, not feds?
No, yeah, he was in state.
I've heard some shit like that in Florida, but I don't know. I ain't never heard it put like that. People see it, but they act like they don't see it. You know what I'm saying?
Yeah, exactly. Like that kind of shit.
So during all that's going on and you're getting in relationships and you're saying these girls are hooking up, what would you think is the percentage on the girls that aren't gay and then hook up with another chick when they're in prison and then become gay?
Probably like 80%.
So I was gonna say like 95.
Okay, just feel like this, like you see all the video, like college chicks, it ain't shit to see two chicks like making out at a bar, like getting drunk, having a good time, woohoo type shit. That's not a big deal. That don't really make them gay. It's just two chicks fucking around. That's how it is in prison. They're just, it's just something to do. It's just, you got, everybody gets so caught up. It's like you forget that it's a fucking world out there. So you're ready to risk it all. And it's stupid. It's so stupid. But you're in there and you don't know that at the time. You know what I mean?
Yeah, out of sight, out of mind.
Kind of, yeah.
All this shit's going on and you're in relationships with women. Where does that turn violent? Is it because, like, you know, your girl cheats on you with another girl, or is it just like you two get on each other's nerves and want to stab each other?
No, it was, so the last girl that I was fucking with. So, okay, so she was a fucking nutcase. I loved her to death. I fucking, bitch was insane. It was awesome. But she didn't give a fuck. She was a white girl and she was little. She was skinny, like 120 pounds. But I used to call her my little UFC fighter. Because she had did TDC time and all kind of shit. So she was about that life, but she was like long blonde hair. If you saw her, you wouldn't know. But like, she would like, for instance, we had just started fucking around. This chick, I didn't really know her. She, you know how it is when the bus come. So, but the new chick was bad as shit. Everybody was talking about her. I didn't even holler at the chick. My girl like met her, introduced herself to her at rec. Like became her friend in 2 days. And literally, I guess the girl said something about thinking I was cute. I don't know. I wasn't there. But she like skipped her like arm in arm, like two girls like walking down the street to the bathroom. And she's like, ooh, come here. Let me show you something. I want to do your hair in the bathroom. And so the girl thought that she was going to take her in there and they were going to do girly shit. And she took her in the bathroom and beat the fuck out of her for no reason. And then it was like everybody. Yeah, it was. He beat the shit out of her, like bad, like beat her up really, really bad. And so it's that kind of shit. Like, it's either.
Yeah, that bitch was crazy.
Yeah, your girl's attacking you or they're fighting another girl.
She beat that hoe's ass because she felt threatened that you might maybe like the chick. So she's like, I'm gonna handle this shit right now.
Yeah, it's called instability mentally. She was just fucking crazy. Right. But yeah, it's that kind of shit. Like, I've never been like too fucked up, like injured. I mean, besides being stabbed, it was with a pencil. So it wasn't nothing like fucking major. You know what I mean?
What would you say is like the most major, like violent, like episode you saw when you were in prison?
Well, there was two. So there was one in Texas and it was another stud and it was two couples, basically. One of the, studs is well known out here, but anyway, they were gonna meet up and fight. So the way the prison is in Texas, in the yard, it comes together like at a T. So they're in the middle is this big ass circle. So you know, in the feds is open compound, so you can just walk all around. And they got to fighting, and it turned into like this fucking Royal Rumble, like it was the craziest shit. for females. It was literally, it was like two femmes and two studs, and they were like trying to fucking kill each other. Like, it took like seven guards, and then in the feds, they didn't walk around with like guns and tasers and all that. They don't do all that. You know what I mean? So they had to like run and try to find shit to break them up like pit bulls. Like, they were trying to like, it was insane. Like, there was blood and shit all over the fucking compound. And then all like in you have to go in a building and then downstairs to get to, there's blood like literally everywhere. It was the scariest shit. And then it was another time when I was in Alabama, this chick woke her chick up by slicing her face up. She was a native, and everybody know how the natives are. They don't fucking play. And I think it was just that short time and shit. Her girl was getting ready to leave. I don't know. They got into an argument, and she fucking, you know, we have doors, and they pop them, and then they, like, at night, they're not locked. So when it's, like, 6 o'clock, you can just get up and walk out. So she walked in her room and fucking sliced her face up while she was asleep.
That's some, like, psychopath type shit.
Yeah, and then she walked to the guard. She went in the room, cut the girl's face up, and it was crazy because her roommate was one of my cool friends, and that shit fucked my friend up because she had to see it. And she said that even the girl it happened to, she didn't make any noise. Like, my friend said she just kind of heard something like underneath her. And she looked down, she's on top bunk, she's down, and she seen the girl like bent over. She just figured it was her girlfriend, whatever they were doing. And then the girl turned around and ran out. And then that's when the girl was like, what the fuck? And started freaking out. And the chick, she walked, she still had blood on all of her hands. She walked to the fucking guard and told the guard, you might want to go check on that bitch. I just fucking cut her up.
That's some gangster shit right there.
Yeah, and fucking walked out. Yeah, they had to. Yeah, they shut the compound down for that one.
So how long total did you do in prison?
7 years.
7 years. So what was, you know, the biggest thing out of your whole situation that you learned, you know, in that process to, you know, make you not want to go back, other than, you know, just being in prison in general?
I mean, I guess it's just like just having your fucking power taken away. You know what I mean? Like, I knew when I was leaving, you know, the second time I felt played because they fucking played me. But it was more of just, you know, not being able to fucking do what you want to do. You know what I mean? And honestly, like, no cap, like, the shit really, like, saved my life. Like, I'm going to scream fuck the feds all day, no doubt. But I did what I did. You know what I mean? But I was, like, in my head at the time, I was on some whole other, like, armored truck, all kind of shit. You know what I mean? So if it didn't happen the way that it did, I probably would have fucking been dead. Now I got like a fucking degree and shit. Like, I'm chilling. You know what I mean? But I see some crazy ass shit in there, and I learned how to fucking hustle, but I learned how to hustle a different way. I, you know what I mean? Like, you got, it's not really about what you do. It's how you do it. And it's how you affiliate yourself with other people, get yourself in situations around people that are positive. You don't got to be a fucking lame. But if you get around a bunch of people that's got fucking money, you'll eventually figure out how to get some too. You know what I mean? But you can't do that shit and be around a bunch of drug dealers, because then you're gonna be fucking selling dope. But get around some other people. Like, so it was bad and it was good. And then I seen how fucking sick and twisted people can be. You know what I mean? It's so easy to manipulate a person's fucking mind. So when I got out, I was like, you know what? I don't give a fuck what's going on. Who got shit to say? I'm going to do what the fuck I plan on doing regardless. And that's what I've been doing.
That's what's up. Yeah, you said a lot of dope shit when you were just talking. It's like, you know, you hang around a barbershop long enough, you're going to get a haircut. And that's like kind of the way I look at like what you're saying. You know, you hang around, you know, people doing negative shit, you're going to be negative. I always look at it like, I always try to surround myself with people that I either – they got something I want, or, you know, they're better off in life than me, because then that makes you, that steps your game up. You feel me?
Exactly. And I always like, because when, you know, when you're in, everybody violates, you know what I mean? And so when I was in, I kept hearing all these stories, everybody come back in like, oh man, my PO did this. Oh, my fucking PO did that. And so I'm like, fuck man, I ain't never going to make it. Right. That's what I'm thinking in my head. I even turned down my halfway house. I declined it. I didn't want it. I was like, fuck that. Why would I go to a halfway house full of fucking addicts and fucking, but then we can't be around felons. It's a fucking setup. So I didn't go, and I'm glad I didn't. But that shit ain't true. Man, my fucking POs, they didn't fuck with me. I didn't even have a fucking piss test the last, all of COVID, all of 2020. And then like the last three months or two. Listen, it got so crazy. Like last year I was getting ready to get off paper. I called my PO to check on her. I called her. And poor God. And hey. She was a white lady. And the reason why I say that is because anybody that knows feds know those fucking white ladies are.
She was probably crazy. Like, bitch.
Yeah, I called her. On FaceTime, and she was like laying in the bed sleeping shit, and she's like, what's up? I was like, shit, I don't know what's up. She's like, what do you want? I was like, I don't know.
Were you trying to pull your probation officer? Don't lie. No,
like I just legit was like,
come on, man.
I was like, I just hadn't heard, and it was like a month before I was getting ready to get off paper, so I was just like, I don't know, I'm just like making sure everything's straight. She was like, yeah. I was like, okay. She's like, did you need something? I was like, no. She's like, okay, well, bye. And she hung up on me. Like she would tell me all the time. She's like, listen, we know what the fuck you're doing. Y'all might, she said that all. She's like, y'all think people, they think they fucking tricking us, but we know exactly what everybody's doing. She's like, I'm not going to waste my time over here. I know what you're doing. I'm over here trying to get these people who are trying to kill themselves and fucking OD. I don't have time to be fucking with you. And that's literally, she didn't fuck with me. And I had two different POs and neither one of them fucked with me ever.
Yeah, you're not lying. Cause like three years ago, I completed felony probation for the first time. And you're not lying. Like when you're not in that life and you're just trying mm-hmm. to complete probation and trying to be, you know, a member of society, you can do it. Like you can do it. Mm-hmm. A lot of that shit is like you said, you hear that shit in jail because a lot of those people are fucking on drugs, robbing bitches, and they get caught, and then all of a sudden now it's, you know, someone else's fault. You got to man up and own that shit eventually.
I look mine because, you know, at first of course they gonna do all that extra shit when you first get out. So I had the second PO, like she had popped up a couple times, and I was staying with my girl. Well, my girl, she smoked weed, so everybody does, right? So when she would come over, the house would smell like weed, so she pissed me. And I told her the last time she did it, I said, listen, you can come over here whenever the fuck you want. I said, I don't care if this, I said, yeah, this house is going to smell like weed. It's not mine. I said, but I'm not going to test for no fucking nothing. I said, y'all ain't going to win twice. Cause to me, that makes me feel like a fucking loser. You know what I mean? Like I already got caught up, did my time. What the fuck I look like allowing y'all to come get me? Cause I wanted to hit a blunt the fuck out of here. I'm not going to do that shit. That's to me. I'm not judging nobody else because everybody got their own struggles and shit. So I'm not judging, but I'm just saying the way I looked at it, I was like, nah, I'm not gonna let y'all get two up on me. That's no. And stand in front of a fucking judge looking all pathetic because of a fucking UA, hell no. And I told her that shit and I guess she believed me because she never tested me after that.
Besides all the probation and all that shit you had to go through, what was the hardest thing for you starting to get your life back? Like, what was like one of the biggest things that was like a hurdle for, you know, you being a felon, getting out of prison? Like, did you have any of those?
Yeah. Well, yeah, because, you know, when you get out, anybody is listening that is on pretrial for the feds, FYI, do not admit to doing drugs. Everybody. No, seriously, this is real advice. Swear to God. Everybody admits it because of the little drug rehab, the potential to be able to get RDAP. So if you do RDAP, you get a year off, right? If you complete it, and then when you get out, if you get in trouble while on probation, they take that year. So you go back for a year. So everybody admits to all this dope and shit, right? But what they don't tell you is if you admit to that shit in your PSI, when you get out, you're going to have like fucking 2 years worth of fucking mental health, drug rehab. Fuck, man, that was the worst part when I got out. I didn't have a car and I stayed in the suburbs. So there wasn't a bus line or anything like that. So I had like three or four different fucking at the fucking dial phone UAs, fucking I had to go to the fucking psych doctor. I had to go to the fucking drug rehab class. I had all this shit. So I'm calling, begging people and shit that I haven't seen in years for rides to get to all these fucking places that they wanted me to go. And I even told my PO, I was like, man, how the fuck? And she's like, well, we'll give you they offered me a bus pass. I said, there's no fucking bus. And she basically just shrugged her shoulders, like, figure it out. I don't know what to fucking tell you.
No cap, though. The reason why they do that is because the majority of people getting out of prison are in the exact same situation that you were. And they know if they put all that shit that you got to do, most people aren't going to be able to do it. And then you just this, you know what that's I'm saying? And that's what they want. And that you got to look at it like you looked at it with that attitude. You looked at it like, bitch, you ain't getting me again.
Real. And then another thing, females, bro, with the fucking halfway house, that shit is fucking fucked up. They put you in a halfway house filled with dudes that also have been locked up for fucking ever, ain't had no pussy. All y'all are together. You're separated by a fucking door. They tell you don't go and talk to them. But guess what happens? Do you know how many females I've seen in my time get violated and sent back pregnant? They take you, the female goes back to jail. The female goes to prison for violating her probation because she's pregnant. So they have proof that you fucked a felon, or you have to lie and deny who your baby daddy is. And no, swear to God, if you put them on
I believe you. I just, the way you said when you fucked a felon or some shit.
But it's fucked up. Like, because you have to put this dude on your birth certificate.
What are you in prison for? I fucked a felon.
Yeah, literally. Like, well, then why would you?
Crazy.
Why would you put them in the same fucking, why would you put them in the same building?
That's, you know, why they want you. They want them fucking.
It's stupid. And then by the time they get fucking sentenced and sent to fucking prison, they're like 7 months pregnant. So then they get like a year and a half, 2 years in jail. So by the time they get out, their fucking baby is like two. You know what I mean? It's fucking dumb. The baby daddy got like two more cases by now. It, like, he never goes. He never went to jail. I've seen it so many times. I don't know why they do that. And they're so fucking shiesty when it comes to, I don't know. But yeah, they won't take the dude. The dude won't go to jail for that. Only the female.
But you're doing good in life now, right?
I'm straight. I'm good.
All right. Well, that's what it's all about. And that's why I bring people on this channel. You know, maybe some young chick struggling, hearing you talk about it and how raw and real it is, you know, it'll stop her from, you know, maybe making a bad decision. But I really want to just thank you for coming on the channel again. I just want to say good luck with your life. It sounds like you're doing good, and I appreciate you coming on.
I appreciate it, man.
And if you're tuning in for the first time, go ahead and hit that subscribe button and turn your post notifications on all. So every time I drop an episode, you can hear it first. And with that, it's DOC TV, and we're out.